study about multiplying decimals up to 3 decimal places. I have here an example for you to see how do the answers change when multiplying with different numbers with different decimal places. Here, we don't have decimal yet. So, 6 times 2 equals 12. Carry 1. 6 times 5 equals 30, plus 1 equals 31. Carry 3. 6 times 3 is 18, plus 3 is 21. So the answer is 2112. Now, in this case, we have one decimal place. This 2 is the so-called decimal number because it is the number after the decimal point. So here, 6 times 2 equals 12. Carry 1. 6 times 5 equals 30, plus 1 equals 31. Carry 3. 6 times 3 is 18, plus 3 is 21. So this is the answer, but it's not yet finished. We need to count how many decimal places are there. So here we have 1. Therefore, you will also count 1 digit from the right, and after counting 1, write the decimal point. This time, the answer is 211.2. Here, 2112. I hope you would see the difference. Another here, we have 3.52 times 6. So again, 6 times 2 equals 12, carry 1. 6 times 5 is 30, plus 1 is 31, carry 3. 6 times 3 is 18, plus 3 is 21. That's the answer, but you need again to count how many decimal places are there. Here we have the decimal point and 1, 2. So here we will also count from the right, 1, 2, point. So the answer now here is 21.12. So you see the difference? Then number 4, here we have 3 decimal places. They are 3, 5, and 2. So we will multiply again. 6 times 2 equals 12, carry 1. 6 times 5 equals 30, plus 1 equals 31. 6 times 3 is 18, plus 3 is 21, carry 2. 6 times 0 is 0, plus 2 is 2. Then, this is the answer, and count the number of decimal places. 1, 2, 3, count again from the right. 1, 2, 3, and point. So for number 4, the answer is 2.112. Okay? Now, for number 5 is the multiplier and the multiplicand both have decimal point here. So, we multiply again like multiplying whole numbers. 6 times 2 equals 12, carry 1. 6 times 5 equals 30, plus 1 equals 31, carry 3. 6 times 3 is 18, plus 3 is 21. Then, before going on, we need to count how many decimal places are there. We have here 2 decimal points. So we will count these numbers after the decimal point. 1, 2, 3. We will count the digits after the decimal point. So we have here 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. The answer is 2.112. Okay? Then, here, there are some additional information here about multiplying decimals by 10, 100, and 1,000. Example, 32.7 times 10. Point is there. If the multiplier is 10, you will just move the decimal point one time to the right. Therefore, the answer is 327. Another, let's say we have 32.7 times 100. The multiplier is 100. There are 2 zeros. You will move the decimal point 2 times to the right. 1, 2. But here doesn't have number. You will just add 0. Therefore, the answer here is 3,270. Then, here, the multiplier is 1,000. The decimal point is there. Here, there are 3 zeros. We will move the decimal point 3 times to the right. 1, 2, 3. And there are 2 curves that don't have number. So we just write 0. Therefore, the answer now is 32,700. So for your homework, please answer student's book pages 21, 22, and 23. Thank you.